I had CO2 laser treatment done 4 months ago, and now I have hyperpigmentation. I had CO2 done on my cheeks and forehead 4 months ago, and now I have discoloration and redness. Seems like the treatment made my skin worse. What should I do? It's not fading away. I smoke, by the way.
Thank you for your question. You stated in your question that you had CO2 laser done 4 months ago, and you're concerned about persistent redness and discolorations. You also mentioned that that you feel like your skin is worse and that you are also a smoker. Well, certainly I can give you some guidance as to what my assessment of your situation is. Of course, this is in the absence of a physical examination or directly seeing what you're describing, but certainly the photos give me some reference point to begin with. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon, and I've been in practice for over 20 years, and I've been using the CO2 laser since the mid-90s. And I can give you certainly my perception of what I think was the desired treatment and what you're experiencing now. So from the photos, it appears to me that you're young, and that the indication that I would suspect you may have had for CO2 laser would have been something like acne scars or even some discolorations. Now, without going into my own philosophy on how I treat people who are younger, I tend to be more conservative about the use of lasers on younger people. But I would suspect that if you were treating acne scars, that the goal of the laser is essentially to try to cause the scarred skin to look less obvious compared to the adjacent skin. And invariably what that means is you have to generate a lot of heat and you have to ablate or remove a decent amount of skin to allow the skin to kind of feather in as well as to tighten over this time frame. The deeper and more aggressive the laser, the longer the redness and the discolorations. As part of a strategy, I think that your doctor probably gave you these possible outcomes as part of the risks and benefits of doing this procedure. And I would be surprised if you didn't see your doctor and the doctor didn't recommend any type of bleaching creams or skin lightening creams or things to deal with this, and sometimes even a steroid cream or something to help mitigate the redness and the pigmentation. Something that I would also suggest that you do as an action item is to stop smoking. People who smoke are unfortunately essentially addicted to the effects of cigarette smoking, which is basically in line with the nicotine effect. And what that basically means is that in order to get the sense of well-being from nicotine, you are trading off the breathing in of carbon monoxide, formaldehyde, and the generation of what's called free radicals. I'm sure you've heard this before, but what that does is it literally chokes the oxygen away from your tissue. And one of the things that we always, always emphasize to people who smoke is the actual limitations of what we can do in cosmetic procedures on people who are smokers compared to non-smokers. People who smoke tend to have problems with healing. People who smoke tend to have longer periods of inflammation. And unfortunately, it is hard for people to stop smoking. But in certain types of situations, I just won't do surgery on someone who smokes, such as in a facelifting operation. An exception to that is something like eyelid surgery, where thanks to the dual circulation to the eyelid area, even smokers are able to do well. In your situation, I don't think you're doing any good by smoking. So I would say do the best you can. Maybe this will be the reason to stop smoking. Fascinating thing about the human body is that in medical studies done on the wound healing of people who smoke and then stop, that literally within 30 days after stopping smoking, the body can heal in a way that's comparable to somebody who's never smoked in their life. So it's just a remarkable aspect of the amazing machine of that is the human body. So that being said, I would also, for patients who have come to us with similar situations from other practices, we've used things like platelet-rich plasma to help stimulate skin quality by improving circulation and improving the collagen. You know, platelet-rich plasma is derived from your own blood, and it's a concentration of growth factors that stimulate new blood vessel formation and the formation of collagen. This was revealed or developed first by oral surgeons who needed that in the bone, in the mandible, in the jawbone, in order to be able to place titanium posts for dental implants. So it can be a value, but the benefit of PRP can be outweighed by the negative of smoking. So if you haven't figured it out, I can't say enough about how bad smoking is for you, and in particular when you're doing something that to improve your appearance, definitely stopping the smoking is important. So that being said, I think you need to go back to your original doctor who did this treatment and understand what their strategy is and how to manage you. A lot of times people just say wait it out, and sometimes it's fine. It's because the pigmentation will fade and the redness eventually does fade most of the time. So it's not like just observation alone is not, you know, is not okay. It is okay based on your doctor's knowledge, experience, and assessment of your situation. But at least you have some additional information to help guide you as to what to do moving forward. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.